got pulled over for a busted tail light in the back.
Told him not to beat me, friend. I told him to get his hand out.
He ain't killed my boyfriend.
Teaching both the theoretical aspects of nonviolence as well as the practical application.
Took away a man with children who depended upon their daddy.
Your history is extremely uncomfortable for America. They'd rather shrug you off or shoot you dead in cold blood. You remind America that they still haven't done right by you. You're powerful, brothers and sisters. And never forget your power of choice. And while your humanity appears to be at risk, remember that you are divine and that you have the power to choose. To choose how you react, how you walk, how you talk, how you protest, how you spend your money. Let's start thinking about these new rituals as we move forward.
John Crawford.
Here.
Tanisha Anderson.
Here.
Dante Parker.
Here.
Tamir Rice.
Here.
Tony Robinson.
Here.
I think there is contagious quality in a movement like this when everybody talks about nonviolence and being faithful to it and being dignified in your resistance. It tends to get over to the larger group.
Say his name. our fathers and mothers are killed, and we can't even see them anymore.
That's right.
It's a shame that we have to go to that graveyard and bury them.
May we look to the past at those who have already walked this path and see what they have done, and see what things we might need to learn from and tweak as we move forward.
And we have tears, and we shouldn't have tears.
We have to say their names so that America can remember that we have work to do. We have to see their names so that America can remember that we have work to do. We have to feel their names. America, we got work to do.
We need our fathers and mothers to be by our side.